Why are ants the best drivers? Why are cars often stuck in traffic?
Are you crazy?
Why do ants never stand still? Why does traffic run so smoothly on their highways? Why doesn't that work for us drivers? Why do we have traffic jams everywhere across the world? What can we learn from ants? What do they do differently?
They are very cooperative. That means they do not block something because they are working on one common goal. They would like to draw food into their nest.
Ants are better drivers in some sense than they are cooperative.
But why? Why is that the case with ants? Why don't they have traffic jams? And what can we drivers learn from them?
Ants basically create colonies with a social structure in which its members have different professions and tasks. They work as a team to tackle problems.
We drivers, on the other hand, are self-absorbed individuals who just want to reach our destination fast.
The main reason is that you do not have enough capacity. Of course, there are other reasons, but these reasons are not that, they do not happen that often. Some people sometimes make driving mistakes, of course. For instance, they do not pay enough attention and then they have to brake hard.
Individual mistakes. Can that explain all the traffic jams, or is there more?
Roadworks, then accidents and heavy weather conditions. But most of that, 60%, 70%, it depends on the region where you look at, is due to overload on the roads. Too many cars at the same time on the same route in the same direction.
And that can have quite an impact. Here's a small selection of the longest traffic jams. Around 2.5 million people fled Houston before Hurricane Rita hit on September 21, 2005. Traffic heading towards Dallas was backed up for 2 days and 160 kilometers. In Brazil, during the 2014 Soccer World Cup final, a traffic jam starting in Sao Paulo reached a length of 344 kilometers. That's almost all the way to Rio. And in Moscow in November 2012, the heavy Russian winter resulted in catastrophic congestion for 3 days and three nights, locking down the main highway between St. Petersburg and the Russian capital. So how can we plan car traffic better? How can we avoid traffic jams? What do ants have over us? Is it just their behavior?
With ants, it really is a case of one for all and all for one. But with car drivers, it's more along the lines of how do I get to my destination as quickly as possible? It's all about individuals doing their own thing with zero consideration for anyone else. And that's something some drivers could learn from.
The drivers on the road are non-cooperative, so they're egoistic. And that is a thing which hinders the whole system to be effective.
On the road in Germany's largest city by far, Berlin. I can't see a thing. Compared to other cities around the world, traffic in Berlin isn't bad at all. Let's take a look at some of the worst. In the Philippine capital, Manila, drivers lost an average of 100 hours of their time stuck in traffic in 2022. Bogota has the worst traffic in South America. Drivers here spent an average of 130 hours in traffic congestion. That's over 5 days in a year. No wonder road rage is a problem here. And in Bangalore, drivers were stuck in traffic for an incredible 134 hours in 2022. That would never happen to ants. They simply have better traffic rules.
Ants communicate chemically. They use a mix of pheromone signals, like watch out, or there's food here, or go this way.
They work for their community. They want to have the system optimum. They want to have a working or a flow which is not stopped by individuals. So we can learn from the ants, but I don't think that one can teach the people to behave like ants.
Especially seeing that people get even more aggressive when they're in their cars.
Many people have a very, very strong time schedule. And if there is a jam which they don't know, they become very angry. They are in their car anonymous. Nobody knows your name. So the people then do within the traffic situations more things they normally would not do.
Are you crazy?
So they like this kind of adrenaline. Not me.
The car is more or less your private environment. It's like at home. It's more or less an addition, an add-on to your home. And you don't like that other people come near to you. So there is a limit about 50 centimeters. So if other cars come close to you, you don't like it. You become angry against the other drivers.
That aggression behind the wheel is also one of the main causes of traffic jams. So why are ants so much better behaved on the road?
First of all, they're driving not that fast. It means if they crash, well, it's just when two people hit each other on the road. So in a certain sense, it is not really dramatic. Yeah. So this definitely leads to the fact that they can have much closer distances, of course, between each other. While cars have to have some distance in order to stay safe.
Then again, there are around 20 quadrillion ants in the world.
You could say that ants have a kind of early warning system inherited by each generation from previous ones, whereas we humans need technical solutions.
Speaking of us humans, how much time do people in Germany spend stuck in traffic every year?
The kilometers driven on German roads per year are more than 500 billion. And within these kilometers they drive, they stand still for some time. So in jams, stuck in jams. And that is about 530,000 years per year that the people are standing still.
Self-driving cars might prevent that by helping us stay relaxed in the stream of traffic, just like the ants.
In the future, we will have automatic systems where we can copy the behavior of ants. And this is the hope that then at the end we will have a working traffic system which has a much larger capacity as we have today.
Learning from ants means learning to win, at least when it comes to avoiding traffic jams and behaving well in traffic. What are your experiences? Do you also have a lot of traffic jams? Write to us. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel.